As of mid-2024, there has been a drastic shift in the BI landscape that we at Datagaps have noticed. It is the migration of BI technologies. Many project managers and architects have either opted in for this shift or are pushed in to accommodate this by upper management. While the exact reasoning for this mass migration is undocumented, we believe it's a combination of consolidation of multiple BI technologies, result of cost-saving measures, and a general attitude shift from legacy to modern BI toolsets, mainly due to a dearth of active expertise. Power BI and Tableau seem to be the top contenders in the shift of these new technologies, with a good chunk of Tableau workspaces themselves being migrated into Power BI. That said, SAP or legacy business objects, Oracle Analytics, Cognos, MicroStrategy, and Qlik are part of such migration projects as well. In our previous video, we touched on some of these challenges. Now, with further experience in these migration projects, we have identified the main pain points, which include the following. Working with completely different technologies. While there are managerial concerns about working with multiple teams with different expertise, this problem extends to the validation solution use cases as well, as the validation needs to be done by a system that uniquely understands both the tool sets. This makes custom frameworks much more difficult to implement and use, as the user base and the tech stack for the two BI tools are inherently diverse. Validation of data and KPIs. The most important aspect of any migration is that the numbers in both the reports should match. The focus can also be on the underlying data model, but the actual numbers seen by the end users are usually the ones with the priority. These numbers are the ones affected by filters or slices or parameters, depending on the BI tool in question. Not only should the numbers and graphs be matched for the default unfiltered version of the reports, but also for all permutation and combination of filters, slices, or parameters defined in that page, visual, or report. This requirement skyrockets the validation time out of any manual possibilities. From an end user's perspective, learning a new tool in itself is quite an arduous task. Thus, any difference in the deployment of their favorite filters or equivalents is deemed unacceptable. This implies that even in a different BI tool, these meta report elements need to react either exactly or as closely as possible to their counterparts. This makes meta report element validation essential. Since BI tools inherently create their visual elements and reports in a distinct manner, the exact same report from two BI toolsets will be visually different. This is due to different scaling, margins, color schemes, visualization methods, borders, just to name a few. While most projects do not require this type of validation as a must and rely on the creator of the reports to ensure similarity, it is an important validation for an end user. Thus, a smart visual-based regression is needed. Loading times, concurrent user capacity, and report responsiveness in a single BI system is hard to govern by itself. Adding them to the concept of keeping them comparable with another BI tool creates a difficult technical problem statement for developers and QA testers. While this might not be the first concern for developers, it is often the first thing noticed by the end users when they interact with the new BI tool. Thus, a validation use case for performance benchmarks is critical for such migration use cases. Security models are on the same page, and while this is left up to the admins of the systems to cross-compare, some rule-based validations on top of the critical KPIs to ensure that the correct user base has access to the intended reports is essential. All the above pointers while being deployed on a small scale can be handled with a dedicated team over the course of multiple weeks in a manual or framework-based approach. This will involve manual testing, induced errors, and biases. However, on a larger scale, these migrations are nearly impossible without automation, both in terms of execution and validation. Ideally, the validation should be performed automatically with the results saved up and notifications sent ahead. The results of these test cases should also be on a proper dashboard that gives the overall picture on validation cycles, calls out only the mismatched reports in the slew of hundreds of thousands, and lets the end user zoom in to the exact mismatch in terms of both the report page element as well as the exact type of issue. These migration projects come in all flavors, such as SAP BO to Power BI or Tableau, OBI EE to OAC, Tableau to Power BI, MicroStrategy to Power BI, and other such. With the large scale and criticality of these projects, the above pointers are applicable and must be considered when planning and executing the migration as a whole. For more details and in-depth discussions, feel free to contact us at datagaps.com.